So what are we doing over here today? करने physical properties के लिए थे halloarenes के और haloalkanes के. Today we are going to do some of the chemical properties of haloalkanes. Okay? Now when we talking of haloalkanes, they are one of the most reactive organic compounds which are going to be present. Because the halogens which are added or which are you can say attached to the carbon chain, they due to their polar nature they behave as good leaving groups. Okay? तो क्योंकि वो इजीली लीव कर सकते हैं, therefore the cleavage of the bond that can take place, and hence haloalkanes they are going to be the one of the most reactive compounds in organic chemistry. Now when we talking of chemical properties, we are going to do four type of reactions over here. The first one which we will discuss, they are known as nucleophilic substitution reactions. These are one of the most common reactions of haloalkanes. Nucleophilic substitution reactions. Now nucleophilic substitution reactions का मतलब क्या हुआ कि we are going to substitute the halogen with a nucleophile. Okay, that is what nucleophilic substitution reaction is. This is the first which we will do. Apart from this, we will also discuss certain elimination reactions. Then we will do reduction reactions, and finally we will do reaction of haloalkanes with metals. Okay, so let's first today discuss about this reaction. When we're talking of nucleophilic substitution, as I just told you, कि जब भी हम किसी nucleophile के साथ substitute करेंगे, that is known as nucleophilic substitution. So let's understand what a nucleophile is. A nucleophile, that is an electron rich species, or in other words, we can say that it is nucleus loving or electron rich species. The nucleophiles, they may be of two kinds. They may be, number one, negatively charged, right? So all the negatively charged species, like we have cyano, we have chloro, we have hydroxy, okay, and we have say bromo, Br negative. So all these negatively charged species, they are going to behave as nucleophiles. Then the second, we have neutral nucleophiles having a lone pair of electrons. So all the species, like we have ammonia, we have amines, or we have water, all of these, they are going to behave as neutral nucleophiles which are going to have one lone pair of electrons. Now when we are looking at the haloalkanes, they are represented by Rx over here. Okay, now R, that is going to have a slight positive charge, and X is going to have a slight negative charge. Why? Because the X over here, that is going to be electronegative. So as a result of which, the lone pair of electrons, they shift towards the shared pair of electrons, they are going to shift towards the halogen. So halogen, that is going to get a slight negative charge and a positive charge. Now over here, this particular part, this is known as the alkyl part, and this particular part, that is known as the leaving group. Okay, now over here you will see that the halogens, they are behaving as the leaving groups, and also it is pointed out that better the leaving group, more effective is the substitution reactions. तो जितना अच्छा leaving group होगा, उतना ही substitution reaction ज्यादा होगा, and it is also seen that iodides behave as best leaving groups. So iodides की substitution जो है वो सबसे easily हो सकती है. Okay, और इन सब में fluoride, that is going to be the poorest. Fluoride, that is going to be the poorest leaving group. ठीक है. सो इन दैट ऑर्डर अगर हम लोग ऑर्डर ऑफ रिएक्शन करें या ऑर्डर ऑफ सब्स्टिट्यूशन रिएक्शंस करें विद डिफरेंट हैलोजन्स, इफ यू टॉकिंग ऑफ इलेक्ट्रोनेगेटिविटी डिफरेंस, तो इन दैट केस द इलेक्ट्रोनेगेटिविटी डिफरेंस के अकॉर्डिंगली ऑर्डर ऑफ रिएक्टिविटी क्या होना चाहिए. इट शुड बी CH3Cl because chlorine that is going to be highly electronegative, फिर उसके बाद CH3Br and then finally it should be CH3I. So this is the expected order of reactivity over here because of the higher dipole moment of CH3Cl which is approximately 1.94d. ठीक है, उसी तरह से CH3Br का कितना होता है 1.790. So you can see that it is lesser. So the electronegativity difference that is going to be less. And in case of CH3I, it is 1.640. Right? But in reality, the order of reactivity is opposite to what is expected. So when we're looking at order of reactivity, the correct order of reactivity is that CH3I that is most susceptible to nucleophilic substitution reactions. उसके बाद we have CH3Br and then we have CH3Cl and least is going to be CH3F. Now why this order that is going to be seen? Why this is a true order of reactivity? The reason behind this is that the size of the halogens, you can see that keeps on decreasing. So as the size will keep on decreasing, the bond length that will also keep on decreasing and the bond dissociation energy will increase. So as a result, the bond length in case of CH3I has a maximum bond length. So because of that, it has least bond dissociation energy. And because it has the least bond dissociation energy, therefore this bond can be easily cleaved. Okay? So we can write down that because of this cleavage of bond, cleavage of bond is going to take place most easily and hence the true order that is going to be this CH3I सबसे ज्यादा, फिर CH3Br, फिर CH3Cl और फिर उसके बाद CH3F. Right? So this is depending upon the bond dissociation energy over here. Let's go on to certain reactions, substitution reactions of haloalkanes. So when we're talking of reactions of haloalkanes, the first which we are going to do over here, that is substitution by hydroxyl group. So OH negative is going to substitute the halogen over here and alcohols they are going to be formed. So if you're looking at the general reaction, it is RX plus KOH. The KOH which we are going to take over here, that is going to be aqueous. Okay? Aqueous KOH, and then we heat the reaction mixture when we will get alcohol plus KX. ठीक है, सो लेट्स डू द रिएक्शन ओवर हियर. इफ यू आर टेकिंग CH3 CH2 Br प्लस एक्वस KOH व्हेन हीटेड, दिस इज गोइंग टू गिव अस CH3 CH2 OH प्लस KBr. ठीक है, द रिएक्शन कैन आल्सो टेक प्लेस विद मॉइस्ट सिल्वर हाइड्रोक्साइड. So we have CH3 CH2Br plus AgOH. This is going to be moist, right? And इसके साथ हम react करते हैं. Again we are going to heat it over here. And this is how it is going to be substituted. ठीक है, सेकेंड जो इसमें रिएक्शन आएगी दैट इज सब्स्टिट्यूशन बाय
alkoxy group. Now formation of ethers is going to take place over here, so we are reacting it with sodium alkoxide. When this NaX that is going to be removed and we are going to get ROR plus NaX. This reaction is a method of preparation of ethers, and this is known as Williamson synthesis, which we will be doing later when we go to ethers. Okay, so let's take an example over here. We are going to take CH3, CH2, Br plus NaO. C2H5 इसको heat करा, so we will get what? We will get CH3, CH2O, C2H5 plus NaBr. ठीक है? So this is substitution by the alkoxy group. Then third we have over here substitution by cyano group. Substitution by cyano group. Cyano group is the CN group. Okay, this is what cyano group is. So over here we are going to react it with KCl. So we have RX plus KCl. This is going to give us RCN plus KX. Right? So let's take an example over here. We have CH3, CH2, Br plus KCl to give us CH3, CH2, CN plus KBr. This is going to be the reaction which we have over here. Now the RCN which is formed over here, that is one of, you can say, major reagents to form many other compounds. Now you can see over here that when we are talking of the reactants, in case of reactants there are only two carbon atoms present, but over here in case of products there are three carbon atoms present. So this is known as an upgradation reaction. Upgradation means that this reaction can be used in conversion from smaller alkyl groups to higher alkyl groups. ठीक है? यहाँ पे there are only two, यहाँ पे there are going to be three. So अगर इससे आपको, जैसे आपको example conversion आता है कि ब्रोमो इथेन से आपको प्रोपेनोइक एसिड बनाना है, सो उसमें आप क्या करोगे, पहले ब्रोमो इथेन को केसीएन के साथ रिएक्ट करके साइनो प्रोडक्ट बनाएंगे, एंड आफ्टर दैट दिस साइनो प्रोडक्ट कैन बी यूज्ड टू मेक मेनी अदर प्रोडक्ट्स, जैसे फॉर एग्जांपल इफ यू आर टेकिंग आरसीएन, राइट, और आरसीएन को हम सपोज रिएक्ट करते हैं या हम इसकी पार्शियल हाइड्रोलिसिस करते हैं. So partial hydrolysis that is done in presence of concentrated HCl. So if we are reacting this with concentrated HCl, we are going to get an amide. This is known as partial hydrolysis of RCl. ठीक है? Similarly, अगर हम इसकी complete hydrolysis करें, complete hydrolysis that is done in presence of dilute HCl. Complete hydrolysis अगर हम इसकी करेंगे, this is going to give us an acid, RCOOH, dilute HCl के साथ complete hydrolysis, और we can also do the reduction over here, and the reduction that can be done in presence of lithium aluminium hydride, or it can be done in presence of sodium in ethyl alcohol. So this is going to give us an amine. Is it clear? So this is one of the major, or you can say one of the reagents or reactants which is used for conversion of smaller alkyl group to a larger alkyl group. Right? So it's complete hydrolysis that is going to give us
sorry, it's partial hydrolysis in presence of concentrated HCl, it will give us amide. It's complete hydrolysis in presence of dilute HCl will give us acid. And it's this thing, reduction in presence of lithium aluminium hydride, that is going to give us what? It will give us an amine with higher number of carbon atoms. ठीक है? So this is one important reaction. और यहाँ पे ये जो reaction है हमारी, this reaction, that is preparation of amines from RCN by reduction, this reaction is known as Mendius reaction. This also we will do later when we do the amines, but as of now you can just remember that this reaction, reduction of RCN to form amines, that is known as Mendius reaction. Okay, then next we have reaction with the fourth reaction which we have, that is reaction with AgCl. Now this is one characteristic feature which we are going to discuss over here. In case we are reacting with KCl, we are getting a cyano product. Okay, but when we are reacting with AgCl, we will see that we get a isocyano product. So let's see what is the reaction over here. If we are reacting, Rx with AgCl, this is going to give us RnC. RnC plus AgX. Let's take an example. We are taking over here CH3CH2Br plus AgCl. This is going to give us CH3CH2NC plus AgBr. Now why this is happening? Why with KCl we are getting cyanide and with AgCl we are getting isocyanide? The reason behind this is that when we are talking of KCl, KCl that is going to be an ionic compound, which means that it will dissociate in aqueous solution to give us K positive and Cn negative. ठीक है? अब यहाँ पे जो ये Cn negative यहाँ पे बन रहा है, this is an ambivalent nucleophile. You know what an ambivalent nucleophile is? That it can link through carbon, it can also link through nitrogen. ठीक है? So it's an ambivalent nucleophile which can link through carbon and it can link both through nitrogen. Now since it is seen that the CC bond that is going to be stronger than CN bond, right? The carbon-carbon bond is stronger than the carbon-nitrogen bond. Therefore, the preferred product over here that is going to be cyano, because this carbon that will bond with the carbon of the alkyl group. So we are going to get cyano over here. But when we are talking of AgCl, AgCl that is a covalent compound. Now because it is a covalent compound, the carbon is not free to form bonds with the carbon of the alkyl chain. Therefore only nitrogen is free over here. So this is going to give us isocyanide product. Okay? So this is the reason why with KCl we are getting a cyano and with AgCl we are going to get a isocyano. Okay, then let's go on to the next reaction. Next reaction, the fifth reaction, that is substitution by amino group. Substitution by amino group. Now in case of amino group, we are going to react it with ammonia. So this is going to be the plan of the reaction over here to give us amines. Now this reaction that takes place in a sealed tube at a temperature of 383 Kelvin, when this HX that is going to be removed and we get an alkyl amine. The reaction does not stop here because RnH2 can further react with
Rx to give us dialkylamine. And then this is known as primary amine, this is known as secondary amine. Then another molecule can react over here to give us trialkylamine. This is a 3-degree amine, right? And plus HX. And finally, we can also obtain a quaternary salt over here. This is what a quaternary salt which we can obtain by reaction. Then the next is substitution by next reaction which we have, that is substitution by nitrite group. Substitution by nitrite group. Over here we are going to react the alkyl halide with KNO2. So KNO2 again, that is going to be ionic over here. What is the reaction? We have Rx plus K positive O(N) double bond O. This is how you can show the KNO2. Okay, so we are having Ka positive and we are going to have oxygen negative over here. This KX that is going to be eliminated. So we have RONdouble bond O. So this is the formation of nitrite which is taking place over here. Alkyl nitrite or nitrate to O you can also say, because it is forming a bond with oxygen over here. Okay? Now over here if we are wanting to form a nitro group, so in that case we reacted with AgNO2. Now AgNO2, that is going to be a covalent compound. So we have over here Rx plus AgNO2 over here, the bonding that is going to take place between nitrogen and R. So we have over here RNO2 plus AgX. So the reason would be same. If we get a question that why with KNO2 we are getting nitrite and why with AgNO2 we are getting nitro. So KNO2 is going to be ionic in nature, oxygen that is going to be free over here, and oxygen and carbon bond is going to be stronger. Okay? Whereas with AgNO2 it is covalent and oxygen is not going to free, so the bonding that is going to take place between R and nitrogen. Okay? The next we have over here, that is the substitution by alkyl group. This is again very important reaction, intermediate reaction for conversion. Substitution by alkyl group, formation of alkynes. Right? Now when we are doing the substitution over here, in this case again we are going to increase the number of carbon atoms. So this is again a upgradation reaction. So we are going to react it with sodium acetylide over here. We have Rx this is known as sodium acetylide. Okay? Yeah, alkylamide it is known as, if you are taking the alkyl group. And when we react log react karte hai, this halogen that is going to be replaced by the alkyl group. So you get a higher alkyne over here. This is going to be removed and we will have RC triple bond CR plus NaX. As the number of carbon atoms they are increasing in the product, it is again known as what? It is going to be known as upgradation reaction. Okay? So let's take an example over here. We have CH3Br plus NaC triple bond CH. right? So we can get propyne, CH3, C, triple bond CH plus NaBr. Okay, so the product that is having one molecular extra than what we are getting over here. Is it correct? Have you understood till here? Okay, the next what we are going to do, we are going to club two topics together for our for our class tomorrow. That is, we are going to do the substitution reactions and we will do the optical aspect. This is one topic which we will do tomorrow. Now from this topic you will definitely get one question of Tren's type, right? Which is going to be highly reactive towards this mechanism and which is going to be more reactive towards this mechanism. So this we are going to start tomorrow.